Hello everyone, in this video we're gonna see how to create this really cool path blur effects, as you can see in here, using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and let's go and open the image that we'll be using. Alright, now the first thing that we have to do is to make a selection of the subject. And to do that, it's quite easy. You can just go and choose object selection and select subject. And there we go. As you can see, we have a really good selection. So I will make a copy of this background, and then let's call this model. And after that, I will one click on this layer mask, and this will apply it as a layer mask. All right, now you can keep the background if you want, but for this one, I think I'm gonna create a background in the end of this, so I don't really need this for now, so I'm just gonna hide it. And after that, I will go to the crop tool, and I want this to be wider, so I'm gonna press Alt or Option, and I will make it wider just like that. That's right here. I think it will look really cool. And let's make this a little bit down. Now, the reason why I did this, because a lot of time when you apply blur, it goes actually further and it will be outside of the canvas, and I don't want that. So I want it to be a little bit wider to have our effects in here. All right. Now, I will right click on this model and I will convert it to smart object. And then I'm going to create a copy of it by pressing Ctrl Command J, will duplicate it, and I will call this blur. Now I will go to filter, and I will choose blur gallery, and I will choose path blur. Now as you can see, when you open the blur path, this is what you're going to see. Maybe you will see this red arrow. You can hide them by uncheck this edit blur shape, but we can now use this in a little bit. So basically this blur, it will actually make the object or the subject blur. And the speed in here, you can control the amount of blur that you want or how stronger is the blur go, like in the speed. Now, this blur is set to be in the center. And we don't want that. We want the blur to be in the direction of the arrow. And to do that, you can just uncheck centered blur. And this way, the blur will actually follow the arrow of the that we have in here, this blue one. And for you to have more control, now we're gonna actually enable this red arrows. And as you can see, it will give us more control using this red arrows. So the more I play with these red arrows, the more shape or the more like interesting it will look for the blur itself. So I want it to be a little bit going in this direction. And maybe I can add another arrow in here, and to do that you can just one click outside wherever you want, and one click, and then go, and then double click to stop. And there we go, we have a blur in here set. This one, I think I want it to be a little bit down with the speed, and maybe play with the red arrows again. Alright, something like that. Now the speed, you can't control each arrow alone of the speed. So this speed, it will actually be applied to all the arrows that you have in here. Alright, so let's add another arrow in here and see how it looks. So something like this, I think it looks really interesting. Yeah, just be careful of the amount of arrows that you will add, because sometimes it will create a collision with the other arrows. And actually the rendering of the blur, it will be longer like that. Alright, so I think I'm happy with this. So I will just press OK and wait for it to render. Alright, as you can see, we have our blurring here. Now it doesn't look that much because we don't have a background like this. For example, this is the original background. And as you can see, it looks really interesting. Now you can keep your original background if you want. But for this image, I think it will look more interesting if we create something graphic in here. Let me actually go back to the crop tool and I want to make it a little bit like smaller in this side, something like that. Yeah, something like this. I think it will look cool. All right, now let's go and create a background. So I will go to this layer that we have, and let's actually delete this because we don't want it. And let's create a new layer under it by pressing Ctrl and one click. It will make a new layer under. And let's call this, let's actually call it circle. And then I will go to this elliptical marquee tool. And I want to create like a ground that is a little bit elliptical, just like that. Yeah, I think somewhere right here it will look really cool. And then I want to fill it with white. So let's go actually and choose the paint bucket tool, and let's change the color to white from the in here, and one click, and this will fill it with white. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command D to deselect. After that, I want to apply a blur in this circle, so I will go to filter, blur, and let's actually choose Gaussian blur. And let me see, maybe I will go a little bit around 25 pixels, and I will press OK. All right, now I'm gonna create another layer under or below the circle. So again, I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command and one click to this plus layer icon, and let's call this BG. And then I will go to my gradient this time, and I will make sure that I'm selecting the basic gradient, the first one, and in here I'm selecting the linear. And let's actually change the black color to something grayish, maybe 20% brightness. All right. And after that, I will go in here and I will one click and drag up just like that. I think it's a little bit strong, so let's actually do it again. And let's actually go from the top and have black under just like that. Alright, I think this one will work. Then you can always go to the layer and press Ctrl Command T, and I'm gonna make this a little bit down, and this one a little bit up, just like that. And I think it looks really cool. Alright. Now the other thing that's what I want to do is to actually make a copy of this blur. So I'm gonna duplicate it by pressing Ctrl Command J. And as you can see, it will make it appear more, and I will make it under the model layer. All right. Now, in this first blur that we have on top, I will actually make a layer mask, and then using a brush and black as my foreground color, I will delete a little bit from the places that I don't want the blur to be that visible. I think only the face, just like that. All right. Next, I will apply a gradient on this blur. So I will go and choose gradient map, and then I'm gonna clip it to the blur in here that we have in top. And I can play with the gradient, but actually for this I already have gradient set to be used. I will make sure to upload them for you guys, so you can choose whatever you like. You will have in here like more than 20 gradients. I think there is one that I really like. Yeah, it's either this or this. I think it looks really interesting. Maybe this one. Okay, I think this one, it looks really cool. All right, and I will do the same for the other blur copy that we have under the model layer. I will apply a gradient. So I will go and clip it to the copy of the blur. And again, I will apply the same gradient that we did for the first one. I think it was this one, so I will keep it like that, and I will press OK, and as you can see, it looks really interesting. So I think I will delete more from the face of the model. Alright, I think it looks really cool. Maybe I will add a little bit in this area. Alright, now the other thing that I want to do is to make a shadow from the model in here to be following the light. All right, let's actually group this background first. So I'm gonna select the background and the circle and then press Ctrl Command G and let's call it BG for background. And then I will create a new layer on top of the background group and I will call it shadow. Now I will go to the model layer that we have in here and I will right click on the layer in here and I will select pixels. Make sure that you click inside, right click inside in here to select pixel, or you can just press Ctrl or Command on your keyboard and one click and this will select the pixels. And then I will go to the shadow layer and I will fill it with black color. So I'm gonna press Alt Backspace and this will fill it with black. After that, I'm gonna press Ctrl or Command D to deselect and then Ctrl or Command T to open the transform mode. And I will rotate it to follow the leg of the model. Just like that. And then by pressing Ctrl Command, I can actually control the distort of this and this one too. I want this one to be smaller like that. And the same goes for this one. And this one to be a little bit up, just like this. And let's make it, let's rotate it even more. And then I will right click and choose warp. This one I want it to be a little bit following the circle as a little bit. I think something like that. It will work for now. Now we'll apply a layer mask and then using a brush with a very low flow, like 2 or 3%, I will start deleting using black as my foreground color. I will start deleting from the shadow in here. All right. Now I will select the layer, not the layer mask, and then I will go to filter, blur, and I will choose motion blur. And let's actually apply a little bit of motion for the blur. Maybe it will be in this angle. And let's put the distance around 90 pixels or maybe 85. All right, something like that. And I will press OK. All right, I think it looks really cool. Now I want actually to have a little bit of light reflecting on the model. So to do that, I will select the model layer and then I will create another layer on top. And then I'm gonna clip it by pressing Alt or Option and go in between and one click. And then using a brush, I will sample a color from this. And I have the flow set to 3% with 100% opacity. I will paint a little bit of light on the model, just like that. And I will put down the opacity like 50%. All right, I think it looks all right. Now, the last thing that I want to add is a gradient map on top of everything and then a noise layer. So let's start with the gradient map. Let's actually use one of the gradients that we already have. So let's see, maybe something not that strong. Yeah, I think this one, it will look really interesting. So I will choose it and I will turn down the opacity quite a bit. Then I will put it around 20%. All right, now let's create a new layer on top and let's call this noise. And then I'm gonna press Shift F5 on my keyboard. And in the contents in here, I will make sure that it's set to 50% gray and I will press OK. Now we'll go to filter and I will choose noise, add noise. I will keep the distribution set to uniform, monochromatic checked. And for the amount, I will keep it 5% and I'll press OK. Now I'm gonna change the blending mode of this to linear light. And there we go. We have a really nice path blur in here set with the really cool colors. And that will be our effect. All right, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know what's for more to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.